Buddy, today I'm actually gonna get started on the master grade Sasabi. As you guys can see, it's a pretty huge box. Very big box. On the box, you get some box art photography, such as a whole model kit, front view, rear view. Here goes a headshot, the nice Char Aznable deco. Here's another head view with the front hatch of the mobile suit revealed and open. This is actually where the cockpit is. This was an actual unique mobile suit all in itself, having the cockpit actually in the head instead of having it in the chest unit. Also has some nice gimmicks such as the the sleeves containing the beam savers. And some very unique articulated hands. They're pretty nice and big, master grade articulated hands. I am pretty much eager to build these ones. Here you got a view of some of the thrusters or verniers. This model kit actually has a bunch of thrusters. I'm not sure how many is the count, but I know it's, I think it's well over 7, somewhere around 8 maybe more. As well as, here goes a little bit of the inner frame view right here on the leg. Looks like two, or actually three different shades of colors. Looks like black, a little bit of light gray here in the joints, and a little bit of darker gray maybe. And let's go to the other side of the box, you get some more. You get a view of the funnel system. You get 6 funnels, you know. Here's another view of the container that contains the funnel systems. A little view of the funnels open and closed here, as well as the markings. And this is a unique marking. I actually got some water slide decals for this model kit, especially. Here goes a view of some of the accessories. This is actually a unique weapon. I haven't seen it on much model kits, but I'm kind of interested in building that as well as painting it. You get your B-Max or Heat Hawk. The shield is actually pretty huge itself, so let's go ahead and get into the box though. As you all know, it comes with the cardboard cutout of this actual finished product. And if you actually take a good look, it's kind of faint, but this thing comes in 2 different shades of red. Which on this it's kind of faint, but when I do mine, I'm actually going to make it more presentable so you guys can kind of see and tell the difference. And then, so here we have the shield. I actually already opened this, I don't know what was in it, I don't remember. And like I said, the shield is pretty big for this model kit. Looks like maybe some inner frame pieces here. I noticed the gun is in here actually, and like I said, it's a pretty big model kit and it's a pretty huge gun. So being that this thing is so big, it probably might even make it easy to build too. Here goes the manual, standard. Also has a backstory, as you guys can see. Go into some more here. These are some actually huge polycaps. I haven't seen those kind of polycaps before. They're pretty big. This actually would go, I believe this actually goes on the shield. Center black piece. Might do that gloss. Here's some green effect parts. I actually cut them out because I wanted to see how well they work. And you actually get 2 of these, which is the beam savers. So you get 2 of these. And then these are for the Heat Hawk, or the B-Max, as you would call it. There's some more inner frame parts, it looks like. Looks like there's going to be a lot of detailing to be done in there, which is pretty good. Like big model kits with a lot of detailing to be done, that's pretty nice. Some reds. Remember, the reds are actually a different shade of red. So if you look here compared to this red, how this red is a bit lighter than this red is. So actually gonna make sure that gets portrayed very good, so you know, you'll see most of the red here where it's dark, you'll get appreciating of light red and then the dark red over the light red. And then here, it'll be appreciating of dark red and the light red over the dark red. So vice versa, but I'll make sure the effect gets seen pretty good. Got some more dark, you know, pieces here for the frame. You also get some more red here. Yeah, there goes the mono eye, I believe, for the head. There looks to be some dry decals in here and stickers, but like I said, I did order some water slides, so I'm gonna be using actually these water slides on this model kit, because like I said, I'm really not one for stickers. So here's some more red, as you see the differentiation in the color. Here's another shade of darker red here. Some more black inner frame pieces. This looks like it's gonna be pretty fun to put together. Some little tiny pieces. I don't really like dealing with tiny pieces, but I'm gonna get them out of the way ASAP because tiny pieces tend to get lost when you're building. Some more inner frame here, as you guys can see. Some more of your darker reds. Dark inner frame parts here. One more of your reds again. You got your yellows here. And some more of your dark black inner frame pieces. So, let's go ahead and get started on building. We'll be right back. Black Comet, and I recently just did the inner frame, so all the inner frame pieces have been primed so far. My next step is, I'm not gonna exactly start painting the coat that I want to go on these just yet. I'm gonna go ahead and clip out everything else and go ahead and give everything else a primer. I just wanted to see how I was gonna work out everything and what could fit on what exactly right now, because I only have about 3 more of these left, the little styrofoam pieces that I put my sticks in, and I should have about a good couple of sticks left because I have 163 sticks with Gator clips, so I should be good. So that should be good enough for the rest of these parts here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and sand down, clip out and sand down the rest of the red parts. Basically, I'm just gonna sand the nub areas, and possibly any deformalities, which I don't see any. So I'm just gonna do that, and then we're gonna have, gonna go ahead and get started on painting everything, I guess. So whatever is gonna be gray is gonna be left gray. And that might just be the whole inner frame. Well, really, actually, no. Some of these inner frame parts should be black, some should be gray. So I'll differentiate and figure that out afterwards. But, yeah, so far, work in progress is going along great, and hope to see you soon on the next video. Peace.